What's up, all my musicians out there? So I've been meaning to this video for a while. I've seen so many ads kind of pop up on my channel actually for this and other places on the internet, and that is MIDI packs, or basically MIDI files. Should you buy MIDI packs or MIDI files? Honestly, 100% no. I do not think they're worth the money in the slightest bit. In case you don't know, I'm gonna kind of simplify this a lot. When you download or buy a MIDI pack or MIDI file, all it basically is a pre-made a kind of chords and melody for you. Think of it almost kind of like pre-made sheet music. So I bring a MIDI kind of file into my DAW, or basically whatever music production program I'm using. It has like some chords already, it has maybe like a melody, and I can add in any synth I want. I can add in a piano, any VST, any instrument that I want, and it will actually play the exact basically notes that are written within MIDI. So the idea for a lot of MIDI packs, MIDI files is like, hey, you don't want to write your own melody, you don't want to write your own chords because you don't know music theory, just buy this pack for blah, blah, blah dollars. Not worth it. One, like I said, I think you're way better off spending your money in somewhere else. Like get a membership through Splice Sounds or something like that. Or maybe just don't even get a membership, right? You can download all the free VST plugins I've talked about on this channel and boom. The second thing is you can actually get a lot of free project files in the DAW that you have right now completely for free. Like go to YouTube and type in like free Ableton project file, free FL Studio project file. You can even go to Splice, create a free Splice account and download all these project files. And then that way you can decode the MIDI structure. It's just so much more useful to do it that way, because I've even seen some MIDI packs and companies and files that are outrageously expensive when it's just, oh, a C chord, a G chord, an A chord, and I'm like, wow, that's really complicated. You know what I mean? And I'm not trying to like hate on them, because I get that they're trying to really make it easier for a lot of producers, especially in the beginning who maybe don't know music theory, but I think you're way better off taking maybe at least an hour or maybe two just to understand the basics of music theory, just in terms of chords and scales. It might take you a couple hours. Honestly, I think especially in the beginning, it's not as tricky as you think. Just kind of understand the whole idea of like, you know, C major versus C minor. What does that mean? What is the difference between minor and major keys? What is a scale? What is a chord? You know, basically the different key signatures as well. You know, if I'm writing a song in D minor, for example, if you think of a piano, okay, so there's gonna be some white keys and some black keys. So D minor, you Google it, maybe just look it up, be like, okay, D minor is all white keys except B flat, right? And then that's it. You're like, okay, so when I'm writing a song in D minor, I know that I'm just kind of playing in D minor, but anytime I want to play B, I don't play B, I play the black note, which is B flat. And yes, don't get me wrong, writing a catchy chord structure and a melody takes a lot of time. I mean, especially in EDM, with the drop being the most iconic part of EDM, a lot of producers, myself included, write a very simple melody like bum 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 da 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 da, like something like that that just repeats over and over on like a big drop. And sometimes it may take me a few hours, as simple as that melody is, to make that melody perfect, to make it catchy, to make it something that could be stuck in your head. But that is the creative process. And I think that can only happen after you kind of figure it out on your own, after learning, you know, things like scales and chords and whatnot. I'm telling you, it's just not worth the money. Don't waste your time. I've even seen some memberships where it's like similar to Splice Sounds, it was like $10 a month every month for downloading MIDI files. And I'm like, for $10 a month, save $2 a month and just pay $8 a month for Splice Sounds. And one thing I want to stress, I have no affiliation with Splice. I just want to say this because obviously it's very useful for producers. If let's say I'm making a song, and I did one recently called Tsuguru, I needed a Japanese shamisen. Super hard instrument to find. And I was like, shoot, I was like, I don't even know how I'm gonna recreate a shamisen. And I went on Splice, typed in the shamisen, boom, I got a bunch of great samples. I'm like, perfect, now I can chop these up, use these samples from an authentic shamisen player. And that makes my life significantly easier as opposed to trying to dig and try to find this rare instrument or find someone to play it for me. But when it comes to MIDI files and MIDI notes, you just basically just draw them in as chords and scales and different melody structures. It's really not that complicated as opposed to something like Splice or basically something else you can put your money into, that the barrier to get there is a lot more difficult, if that makes sense. Like I said, trying to find a shamisen sample, trying to find a sample of a berimbau from capoeira, very difficult to do so. But trying to find or figure out what's a C chord takes you 2 seconds. And I know I'm rambling on a little bit, but I'm just telling you, it's not worth your money. And again, on this channel, I really like to help out beginning producers. And if you see these ads being like, oh, it might not be a bad idea to just get this MIDI pack, this MIDI file, I spend $5 to $10, and I can add in any synth that I want or any VST or any instrument, and instantly this melody's mine. I can even customize if I want. I just don't think it's worth the money. If you do, like say you do want to study MIDI files themselves, or basically chords and structures and melodies and whatnot, Just download a free Ableton Project file or FL Studio Project file through Splice or through YouTube. Honestly, like, I remember when I first started producing, would go to YouTube, and obviously Skrillex is one of my biggest idols for a lot of EDM artists as well. And I would type in like Skrillex, blah, blah, blah song, project file. And someone would say, hey, I just remade, you know, one of Skrillex's songs. You can download this project file for free. And I download it and study the MIDI and be like, okay, why did Skrillex make this melody in this way? Why did he add these chords in this way? Why did he layer them this way? And I can study it for free as opposed to paying all this money. So I'm telling you, it is not worth your time.